Bonjour and welcome to my channel Anyone Can Cook with Christian and my little friend Mickey. Today we will cook together an absolute classic dish from Disneyland, the Ratatouille, just like in the 2007 film. However, the Ratatouille prepared in Disneyland is a little bit different than in the film. I think mainly for practical reasons, so that you can keep the Ratatouille warm and also you can serve it in portions. But honestly, I like the Ratatouille from Disneyland much more. I can still remember how excited I was when I heard that in Disneyland a new attraction would be opened. The Adventure Ratatouille from the movie with the same name. I've always tried to look behind the fence to see how it would look. And I was thrilled when in July 2014 the attraction was finally opened. The ride was designed just like what you would imagine old Paris to be. There are three different entrances to the attraction. On the right is the normal entrance. On the left, the entrance with Fastpass. And in the middle, there's a single ride. As for the Fastpass and single ride, I will explain more about that in a future video. The films in the attraction are 3D and it's difficult to film the ride. Fortunately, there's a 2D video from Disneyland Paris. And here you can see some clips from it. Let's take a look. You are on the rooftops of Paris as Remy sees for the first time Gusteau's restaurant up close. Before you realize it, you suddenly fall through the glass roof and you are in the restaurant kitchen of Gusteau's, where Red, according to the kitchen staff, shouldn't be. So you have to hide really well. When you escape, you pass through the pantry. There you see a hanging ham, over 6 feet tall and weighing 1.2 tons, and a 6.5 meter high fridge. You end up in the dining area of the restaurant, where Linguini managed just in time to hide you. But not for long. Skinner is hunting you. However, you finally manage to escape. You pass through Remy's kitchen, where the rats prepare everything for cooking. Of course, the fantastic meal needs to be eaten. Therefore, the entire rats gang meet in the arbor under the roof. And there, they have a delicious dinner. When you leave the Ratmobile, you can take a look through the glass windows to the lovely furnished restaurant, Chez Remy. It looks just like the restaurant in the movie. Everything is from the point of view of a rat. There are oversized plates and cutlery and huge jam jar lids that serves as tables. From the ceilings, there are gigantic hanging fairy lights. You have to see that. So now, as we are really hungry, let's start to cook. For the Ratatouille, we will need 2 medium-sized eggplant, 2 green zucchini, 1 yellow zucchini, 3 peppers, 2 onions, 2 cloves of garlic, oregano, thyme, basil and rosemary, 1/2 liter of vegetable stock and 2 tablespoons tomato paste, 700 milliliter of tomato puree and olive oil. First, we cut the eggplant in approx 1 cm thick slices. Since the eggplant contains many bitter substances, I have a special tip for you. Make sure the eggplant slices are properly salted on both sides. The eggplant will start to sweat, and with it, the bitter substances will be exuded. We will rub that in and allow the eggplant to stand for about 10 minutes. Next, we will cut the zucchini. First, we cut them in 1 cm thick slices. And then we also cut them into about 1 cm cubes. With the yellow zucchini, I use only half. We will use the other half later for the decoration. Now we have to prepare the peppers. Personally, I think the ratatouille will taste much better if the peppers are skinned, because the skin is difficult to digest. There are different methods to skin the peppers. The pepper is either roasted on the stove or in the oven. And then the peppers have to be cooled in iced water. I have already prepared some iced water for that. However, the oven method does not work for me. That's why. Kids, please look away now. Don't try this at home. I have the ultimate secret weapon, namely a blowtorch from the hardware store. Ensure that you burn all the skin. And then place the whole pepper in iced water. And now, as if by magic, you can skin the pepper easily. Next, we trim the insides of the peppers, because these are just as indigestible as the skin. We cut the peppers in about 1 cm big cubes. As mentioned already, we will use only half of the yellow zucchini, as we will use the other half later for the vegetable tower. Meanwhile, the eggplant is ready to be chopped. You can see that it has sweated well. The water contains the bitter substances, which we wipe off with a paper towel. Hey Mickey, do you know where the name ratatouille comes from? It seems to be a French word. Rata means rat in French, I know that. The movie is about a rat, but rat is not on the list of ingredients. So, thankfully, there won't be a rat in the ratatouille. You are totally wrong. Ratatouille is a French term, used since the 18th century for stew dishes. Rata is a Provençal term for easy food, and touiller means to stir. We cut the eggplant into 1 cm cubes. And as we are cutting all the vegetables now, we also can prepare the ingredients for the sauce. For that, we need to cut the onions, garlic, and herbs into small pieces. We need them, as I said, later for the sauce. Here we have the rosemary, oregano, thyme and basil. We finally chop the herbs. Now we are done with all the preparatory work. Let's start with the real cooking. I always like to use olive oil because it gives the best flavor. Use plenty of olive oil because the eggplant needs a lot of oil. Use a high heat and stir fry the eggplant. The eggplant seems ready now. As our vegetable soak up a lot of olive oil and we don't want all that oil in the ratatouille, we use paper towels in a bowl to absorb the oil. We are now adding some fresh oil and because of the amount of zucchini we have, we will fry them in 2 steps. So that they are nicely fried. And we will also dab the zucchini with kitchen paper, so that all the oil is fully absorbed.
Tupfen wir auch die oberste Schicht noch einmal ordentlich ab, damit wir das überschüssige Olivenöl aufsaugen können.
And now we can prepare the sauce. For this, we will fry the onions and garlic.
Wir machen jetzt mal etwas Olivenöl dazu.
When the onions are soft and translucent, we add 2 tablespoons of tomato puree to it and cook it for a while. Then we add the vegetable stock to it. At first, just a small amount.
Mal so einen kleinen Schuss.
and let it reduce a little. Then we add our tomato puree. You get a better result with a ratatouille when you use a high quality tomato puree. Now we add more and more of the vegetable stock. And some more tomato puree. We then season with salt and pepper. To reduce the sauce, we will cook it for about 10 minutes. Always watching it closely to make sure it doesn't burn. Tell me, Christian, you said that when you go to Disneyland, you also take short trips to interesting places in France. Where did you go last time? Last time I was in Meaux. It's a pretty small town near Disneyland. Only 20 minutes away, I always park outside and then I walk to the city center. Last time we saw the Bussy Gardens, the Episcopal Palace and the Cathedral. I also liked the facade of the old chapter building. On Saturday mornings, there's always a vegetable market. Close to the market, there are several nice small cafes. It's quite normal to buy croissants or other pastries from a bakery and then eat it all in the cafe. Next time, I would like to visit a cheese dairy in Meaux. They produce a world-famous brie. While the finished dish simmers for 15 minutes, let's prepare the zucchini coat. As you saw in Disneyland, the ratatouille is coated with zucchini. For that, we take a zucchini at least twice as long as our small baking dish. So that we can make the coat completely cover the bottom of the dish. Make sure that the stripes are about the same thickness, so that they have the same cooking time. Personally, I blanch my zucchini slices briefly, so that the cooking time in the oven is not too long. We leave them to drain on some kitchen paper and then we prepare our baking dish. First, we put the zucchini slices fan-shaped in the dish. Paying attention to let a little bit of the zucchini strips hang over the right and left of the dish, so that we can close our ratatouille package totally. Before we will fill the ratatouille into the baking dish, we will taste it again. Mmm! It's delicious, but I think it still needs a pinch of salt and pepper. Now we fill it up with our ratatouille inside the zucchini coat. Take care not to put too much sauce into the dish, to avoid the liquid running out. Then we press down lightly with a spoon. Don't overfill the dish. Fold in the overhangs to make a neat parcel, as we want to turn the dish upside down later. Voilà. While the ratatouille is cooking in the oven, I'm preparing a side dish now. In Disneyland, the ratatouille is served with mashed potatoes or potato pancakes. However, today I'm going to make mashed potatoes with spring onions. Here you can see everything you need for the mashed potatoes. I've also written down the ingredients for the vegetable tower. I will start with the potatoes first. Firstly, slice the potatoes and cook them for about 10 minutes. Next, we finally chop the spring onions into small slices. We mash our boiled potatoes, adding some butter. And then add some milk. Season it with pepper and some nutmeg. And then we add the spring onions and stir everything. For the vegetable tower, we have set aside from the vegetables from the ratatouille. And additionally, we cut some slices of tomato. Now I fry the vegetables for the vegetable tower. First the green zucchini, then the yellow zucchini, followed by the eggplant. And finally the tomato. Here is our ratatouille package. We turn the baking dish over. It already looks very good. Now we will arrange some of our mashed potatoes. I will use a cake ring for that. This looks a bit more elegant. I'm really hungry now. It looks really delicious. We take the cake ring off and we have a wonderful potato tower. Additionally, we can add a lemon schnitzel. And then we will decorate everything with some sauce. Now we decorate our vegetable tower. I start with a layer of eggplant, in between some sauce, then the green zucchini, yellow zucchini, and a tomato slice. One more slice of eggplant. And it looks really beautiful. We decorate the dish with some spring onions and some basil.
Voila! Bon appetit!
A small tip for you. If there is any ratatouille left over, you can make a wonderful pasta sauce with it or add it to an omelette for breakfast. So, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you have a lot of fun cooking. And don't forget, if you like my videos, give me a like, hit the bell and subscribe to the channel. Let me know of any recipe suggestions in the comments below. And if you would like me to cook any other special dishes from Disneyland for you, also let me know. Au revoir, Christian and Mickey. Thank you.